When the subject of the world's wealthiest footballers is brought up, there are many names that come to mind. Most people would probably guess with the likes of Cristiano Ronaldo, Lionel Messi, or even Neymar Jr. But very few would offer Mathieu Flamini as their answer. And yet, the ex-Arsenal midfielder is wealthier than all three of them combined. According to Forbes magazine, Flamini's net worth is over 14 billion euros. For a player who scored just 21 career goals and made just over 400 appearances, the question is now, how has he made so much money? Before we take a look at Flamini's wealth, let's first take a look at some of the richest athletes of all time. According to Forbes, there are only 5 athletes who have become billionaires through their career earnings. Without a doubt, that list will continue to grow in the next 10 years, but the current list of billionaire athletes include Michael Jordan, Tiger Woods, Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, and Michael Schumacher. While many names will join that list, including the likes of both Lionel Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo, the fact of the matter is that as of right now, there are only 5 billionaire athletes. So, where does Flamini factor into all of this? Well, 12 years ago, in 2008, Flamini co-founded a company that he hopes will one day help save the planet. That company is GF Biochemicals, otherwise known as GFB. GFB produces luvonic acid, a chemical that can serve as a substitute for petrol. According to Flamini himself, it cost millions to develop and took years of research and testing. However, if successful, Flamini's product would be entering a market that would be worth 20 billion euros, making him not only the richest football player, but one of the richest men in Europe. Now you may be wondering, how come Flamini isn't yet on the list of billionaire athletes? Well, Flamini isn't technically a billionaire, yet. As he stated in an interview in 2018, he doesn't have billions of euros sitting in his bank account. His net worth is closely tied to the value of his company. Therefore, he isn't technically a billionaire. However, if he sold his stake in the business, he very well could be. Ultimately, however, money isn't what drives the Frenchman. Instead, he's motivated by one goal and one goal only, and that is to save the planet from climate change. Take a look at what the Frenchman said in 2018.
The idea is, since very young, I'm a big fan of documentary, and since a very early age, I've been aware of the problem of climate change and the impact also of chemical product on human health. So the idea was to find solution, and that's why I decided to go in that direction and to take the path of the bioeconomy.
It was during his time at Arsenal that Flamini originally founded his company. In fact, the first time the Frenchman turned up to training in a suit, his teammates were baffled. Many asked if he had mistakenly thought it was a match day. The truth is, the midfielder was keeping a secret. For the previous few years, he had been working on starting his company. During his time at the club, Flamini spent countless hours negotiating deals and taking conference calls in his free time. In an interview with the Financial Times, Flamini talked about how his football career helped prepare him for the business world. He described how he learned so much from the legendary Arsene Wenger. It was his ability to lead and motivate that were some of the main attributes Flamini learned from his manager and mentor. Flamini isn't just a businessman, however. He's a leader for future change. He has made various sacrifices that included recycling more and becoming vegetarian in order to save the planet. Listen to what he had to say about becoming vegetarian in an interview last January.
We need to reduce our consumption of animal protein for the planet. The reality is some people don't care about the planet. So how do you address this message to the people who don't care about the planet? Maybe we should start telling them that having a more balanced diet in order to improve the lifestyle can also be could also be one of the solutions. So depending on who you address your messages, I think it's important to also have a different approach in terms of communication.
Overall, despite having the potential to be the richest athlete of all time, Flamini's focus is elsewhere. Like many of the athletes of his generation, including the likes of LeBron James, Marcus Rashford, and Mesut Ozil, Flamini is trying to start real change in the world. Once more, this is what Flamini had to say about his belief in instigating change as an athlete.
And I've been playing football for a long period of time, and it's true I have a certain platform, And I believe as outlet, we have a social responsibility. Media, they also have a social responsibility because they have the potential to influence people and to influence people to do good out there. So yes, that's true. I've been trying to use my platform to try to influence people to do good out there. And of course, I've been talking about climate change. But I think what's important more than creating awareness today is to provide solutions. I really believe that small changes on a big scale can have a real impact. That's why, I mean, I believe sport, which is one of the only, I would say, industry who can bring people together, has a real role to play.
Without a doubt, the ex-Arsenal midfielder is on a mission, but not one that focuses on football or personal wealth. He's on a mission to make this world a better place. I present the world's richest athlete, Mathieu Flamini.